I think it's about time that we move into a little segment known as the Entertainment Biz and Shiz.
Oh, that should have come before that. Yeah. All right. So, in honor of Lady Gaga's wonderful performance.
Holy Jesus, you don't have to scream.
All I can hear is that music.
Turn your headphones down.
Sorry. All right. Well, like I was saying, in honor of Lady Gaga's performance, these are a few of my favorite things. So, we all know Kim Kardashian, the supreme leader of Instagram, showed off her new hairstyle recently.
What does it look like?
It's just shorter. She literally just like cut a few inches off it. And, you know, Instagram blew up. So
she's still stupid.
Yeah, exactly. But another supreme Kim has debuted a hairstyle, Kim Jong-un.
Oh boy. That's the Kim I know.
Yeah, the supreme leader of North Korea debuted his new do as well, doing away with his previous look, which was a center parted shaved sides cut.
Yeah, the mo, I call it.
It was something. Opted for something a little more hip, I guess.
And wait, what does it look like?
It's similar to the flat top look of the 80s and bears a striking resemblance to Jersey Shore's Pauly D's immobile hairstyle.
Nice.
Yes.
Nice.
Look it up.
I see Pauly D in the video.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. And so, Pauly D.
Douche nozzle.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. He knows what he is, and he's making money off of it while he can. But Pauly D tweeted an Instagram picture of a sort of side-by-side comparison of him with Kim Jong-un with the caption, "Who wore it best? Hashtag Kim Jong-un or hashtag DJ Pauly D?"
And no contest.
Kim Jong-un?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, did it need to be said?
No, I guess not. But yeah, he was, in addition to the hairstyle, he's also sporting some new half-shaven eyebrows.
Whoa, buddy. Hey.
Look like little Hitler mustaches above his eyes.
I didn't know that was a thing, you know?
Is he trying to pick up some ladies?
Yeah, I'm not sure what he's doing, but he's trying to start some sort of trend.
I hope he does like a Costanza, you know, like in his boxers. The photo. Like, all this, like,
on the red velvet couch.
Oh, God, he needs that so bad.
I would buy that.
Yeah.
In fact, we could just crop his head on George's body from that picture.
I promise I will get that up on our Facebook page.
You heard her. You heard her.
Promise.
I've heard other promises from her before.
Hey.
But anyway, speaking of scary things. The topic of the next season of American Horror Story was revealed this week.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. Did you guys hear this?
I'm so excited. No.
It is Hotel.
Wow.
I love your reactions.
Notel, motel.
Yeah. Which I guess the what exactly will go on is kind of debatable. I don't know if they're going to do a Psycho Norman Bates-ish thing.
There's already a television show, The Bates Motel.
Yes, there is. But, I mean, American Horror Story always takes things a little above and beyond. Or maybe something The Shining-esque.
That'd be really awesome. They'll probably kind of mix all of it together. You know how they do.
Yeah, they
stuff,
usually
so.
Have several different arcs going at the mm-hmm. same time. But Lady Gaga is set to star.
Whoa!
Yeah. Awesome. Yep. Which
I hope she dies in the show, of course.
Well, I think is she taking over for Jessica Lange?
Oh, good point.
Is she going to be the new head bitch in charge?
These are all solid questions.
Yes. Well, yes, they are not for you to necessarily answer right now, but these are the questions in my mind. And it's supposed to be set in present day.
At a Lady Gaga concert.
At a Lady Gaga. That's the horror show.
Oh, my God.
But it'll air in October, as it usually does, you know, sometime around Halloween. But this is actually pretty old news, but is news to me because I don't know what rock I've been hiding under. Well, not this particular one. Ryan Murphy, the genius behind American Horror Story, Glee, Nip Tuck, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Genius.
Yes. Yes. You can quote me. The only non-genius thing I've ever seen him do was last year I was in L.A. and I saw him cut off a bus.
Cut off his butt?
Was it a short bus?
Cut off a bus. No, it was not a short bus. All
right, well, that's
not so bad. He would go to hell for that.
Yeah.
Directly.
The ground would have opened up. He would have just been like down.
Just fell. It was so funny, though. We're walking along, you know, outside Paramount Studios, and we're like, holy crap, that's Ryan Murphy. Holy crap, he just cut off a bus, and now he's getting honked at.
Was it a school bus?
No, it was just like
a tour bus.
Yeah.
If it's a tour bus, that's okay.
Yeah.
I'll accept that.
Yeah, I will accept that, too. But anyway, he has two more shows in the works, and I reported on the one a few weeks ago, which is Scream Queens, which will be a horror comedy, like a half-hour thingamajig on
Fox.
Fox.
Yeah.
Will be airing in the fall. Like I said, stars Jamie Lee Curtis, Emma Roberts, Lea Michele, bevy of other stars. But he's also executive producing a true crime anthology series called American Crime Story.
What?
Yeah.
Be original with your crime stories, will you?
Well, I'm a huge fan of true crime stuff.
Like
my
who cut off the bus?
Yes, that was...
Who cut the bus off?
I know who did it. He was in a black Range Rover. Yeah, but anyway, this piqued my interest because Ryan Murphy plus true crime, you know, I watch Investigation Discovery religiously, just blew my mind. But the first season will be focusing on the OJ trial.
Yes.
It's set to, yep, set to air on Fox, or FX, I'm sorry, early 2016. But the new big names are being added all the time, so that's why the story popped up again recently. Cuba Gooding Jr. will be playing OJ.
Cuba.
Damn it. I was really hoping they were going to choose like Eddie Murphy or something. Eddie Murphy would be hilarious.
He doesn't do anything either.
No.
Like,
not
it's
anymore.
Either Disney or bust.
Daddy Daycare. That was a phenomenal movie.
Oh, boy.
Or Nutty Professor like 6 or something.
But also starring in it will be David Schwimmer as Robert Kardashian. John Travolta was just added on as Robert Shapiro. Sarah Paulson, who you may know from American Horror Story, she played the one with two heads for Freak Show.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she'll be playing Marcia Clark. So, yeah, like I said, look for that early 2016 because they're still adding on people, and I'm sure they're going to keep going with the big names.
And it might change, too. Like, some people might drop out or...
Yeah.
Be replaced by other better, bigger names.
Exactly. So, you know, stay tuned for that. But, and of course, my absolute favorite, Glee. there you go. That was my singing. It wrapped up filming this week or last week, I believe, which means there are only 3 more episodes left of the show.
Aww.
The show that Ian Brennan created, who is a producer. He produced this show based on the concept of his own experience as a member of the Prospect High School show choir in Mount Prospect. FYI, bet you didn't know that.
Mind blow.
Blow. But Lea Michele tugged on heartstrings everywhere when she tweeted a picture of her walking off the wrapped set of Glee with Cory Monteith's character, Finn's framed football jersey with the caption, "One last thing." And as we all know, he passed away a year and a half ago, and that was her, the love of her life. So. Wow! Wow! Insensitive. I am calling Whoopi on you.
Both on and off the show, though, too, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Both on and off the show, yeah. So, and I think his dying actually contributed to why they ended it. Actually so soon. I know it's been 6 seasons, but
wait, I got a better one for him.
I swear. I'm gonna kick your ass after the show.
You're lucky you're in the closet, dude.
But in related news, a cast member of American Horror Story passed away recently.
Oh.
Yeah. Ben Wolf, who played Meep the Geek in Freak Show, was recently struck by the side mirror of a passing vehicle while he was jaywalking on an LA street.
Well, you kind of get, you know. Yeah.
But everybody jaywalks there.
Tell you not to jaywalk, though.
Yeah, but I think his short stature, he's only 5'3.5".
It hit him in the head.
Yeah, it hit him in the head.
Oh, my
God. He's 5'3.5"?
4'3.5".
Oh, I'm like, that makes no sense.
He's taller than me.
I know. I'm like, he's as tall as I am. Mm-hmm. Jesus.
Yeah, but at least he's an organ donor, so he saved 3 lives with 2 kidneys and a liver.
That's actually kind of awesome.
Yeah, so, you know.
As long as they don't hand his brain off to somebody.
Why is that?
Because he was jaywalking.
Oh, aha.
Funny.
Yeah, but.
Kapuya!
Yeah, thank you. But, yeah, he was just 34 years old, and so it's sad. He will be missed.
Tragic.
As the one who was biting heads off of little animals.
It's a tragic way to go.
And people were clapping.
Yeah.
Yay!
So, and real quick, I'll mention.
Oh, boy.
Little Miss Zohan here has not changed her profile picture per the agreement when you lost a bet a few weeks ago or lost
that
game.
Not a bet.
Game.
She lost it again.
I don't think I lost a bet.
Well, you know.
I didn't bet that I was going to win, that's for sure.
Well, okay.
Because I don't have I have a Twitter account. I don't use it, though.
Well,
I'm not up to
you don't have to
things.
Do it on Twitter. On Facebook, change your profile picture to that picture we took last week with you holding a sign, and we'll let our viewers be surprised by
maybe,
the sign.
Actually, if I bring the sign with me to the Polar Plunge, what about that?
It's paper.
Well, I know, but it's it'd be funny.
Well, I'm just telling you, if you don't change it very soon, Tim and I are going to come up with a harsher punishment.
To be honest, though, I am jumping into the water tomorrow as Hulk Hogan, NWO era.
Are you going to wear the mustache?
Yes, I'm drawing
Excellent.
It on.
Excellent. Oh, you can't draw it on. You got to buy the hair and the mustache.
Well, I don't have time to now. But
Fantasy Headquarters is probably on the way.